What up, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of The NerdGen Report. I'm your host, Pablo, and joining me, as always, is Mr. Brian Schultz. Brian, we got to run it back, it seems, because we had a stellar outing the other day with the Star Wars show that we put out. Thank you for the support. It seems, Brian, the response to that video just shows one thing, that most people feel the same way. Brian, your thoughts on, because it was crazy. You hit me up and what did you, what was the first thing that you hit me up with? I think the show is going crazy.
Yeah, I was just like,
we hit a nerve.
Oh, that's what I said. We definitely touched on something. Apparently we definitely found something. And it's interesting. Like, I feel like, you know, to the credit of our audience, like, there's still such a passion for Star Wars that spans generations. And we saw it, like, you know, we had our Andor show, which got a lot of response. And then, but I think we found the lightning rod of this entire enterprise, which is the status of Kathleen Kennedy. And I think in a lot of fans' mind, what it's going to take to get new leadership, you know, into Lucasfilm. And I think we're coming back with more information. And I think what we're going to do is almost re-lend Star Wars Celebration, given what's come out after, because I think it will change a little bit how you think of that content. But I mean, thanks again to the people who watched and offered comments and subscribed. Like, we appreciate all of it, and we're glad you enjoyed the take. But there have been more developments since we taped that we wanted to bring into this. And I always point out, like, in Hollywood, I always think of, like, Hollywood as, like, there's generally a pattern to the way creatives and talent speak to the press.
Yeah.
So anytime somebody steps out of line with that pattern, I take note.
Yeah.
Because that usually means something is going on.
Yeah.
And the thing that has continued to come back around is this Kevin Feige Star Wars project. It's amazing. This thing.
You can't just go. I won't let you.
Does it exist? Did it? This has become, like, I don't, it's not quite Snyder's Cut.
Yeah. I was
like, heading in that direction of, like, what actually happened with this?
It's heading in the direction of what was told to Kevin Feige and what Kevin Feige was thought he was going to be able to do. And then someone saying yes, and then saying that never existed.
We went back to, honestly, I just started going back to the archives to pull quotes. But then, and we'll bring it in, we had some, I don't know how else to describe it other than mouse-on-mouse crime at Disney. Because the Russo brothers came out from under the apron with a steel chair, basically, to take sides against Kathleen Kennedy. And so we got to break this down, because it's fascinating. So, the lightning rod quote from Star Wars Celebration this year came from Kathleen Kennedy when this project did not appear, was not mentioned.
Mm-hmm.
And she was asked about its status. And we kind of referenced it cryptically last time, but I thought we'd actually go to the woman herself and get the actual word. So here it is, quote, Kevin Feige's project was something announced in the press, or I suppose fandom, but there was nothing. Nothing ever got developed. We never discussed an idea. As everybody knows, Kevin is a huge Star Wars fan. And if he did come up with something, I would be all ears. But that never really happened. So it's not an abandoned project. It just never really happened. End quote.
Okay.
That same week following the 2019 was a streaming it was like a streaming project. They did some Disney Plus stuff and they did some Star Wars stuff.
Yes.
The official Star Wars YouTube channel announced Kevin Feige as the co-producer of a project with Lucasfilm. In the so it's the Star Wars official channel sent out a communique.
Yeah.
Saying Kevin Feige is co-producing. We then subsequently got confirmation that Michael Waldron was brought in to write a draft. This happened. Yes. Waldron himself confirmed it.
Yes.
In the Doctor Strange 2 promotional tour. And then we get which I think is kind of the nail in the coffin, when the Russo brothers went on a podcast and had no incentive, honestly, to talk about that. They were promoting Citadel for Amazon, which is that's a wild show, by the way. Favorite, but that's a bizarre. Yeah. You want to see Richard Madden's James Bond audition? It's in that show.
Oh yeah, I think he's gonna get it. But go ahead,
because he's pretty good at that. But Joe Russo on this podcast says flat out, we love Star Wars. Kevin Feige is a huge Star Wars fan. There were early conversations about teaming up with Kevin to do his Star Wars. So this never happened?
Yeah.
Saying there were talks for them to direct a Michael Waldron written Kevin Feige Star Wars project. And Kathleen Kennedy standing up there saying there was no idea, no development, and it never happened.
This is the Russos standing up for Kevin Feige, because Kevin Feige is not that type of dude.
No joke. That's what I mean by mouse on mouse crime. This is a MCU house being like, we're coming after the Star Wars.
Yeah. House. But she's not giving up without a fight, though. And that's what this whole thing is about.
But that then tied back to something we had heard prior, which was the whole Harrison Ford Thunderbolts versus Indy 5. You remember that flap?
Yes. Yes.
D23, where Kathleen Kennedy prevented Marvel from announcing Harrison Ford as Thunderbolt Ross because she didn't want that to overshadow Harrison Ford's return in an Indiana Jones movie that looks like it might be dead on arrival.
Brian, when does that movie come out?
June 30th. That movie's going to get wiped. I tell you what, Flash is 3 weeks before. Or sorry, look at this lineup. Transformers is 3 weeks before that movie. Flash is 2 weeks before that movie. And you know what comes right after that movie? Dead Reckoning. Indiana Jones 5 is going to bomb.
Yeah. And it'll be interesting to see the sort of, because Brian, I don't know, I don't care what nobody says. The Indiana Jones VFX don't look great.
No.
I don't care what nobody, and who knows? You know what I'm saying? On purpose, it doesn't look great. It doesn't look great when you see it. It doesn't look great. That looks like VFX.
Yeah, and the thing is, you know, this is, we've seen the whole de-aging exercise attempted a lot of times, right? And it has varied results. There's pieces of Endgame where you're like, wow, that actually looks pretty good.
MCU did a great job with de-aging.
You're rewinding the clock literally on screen to make him look like he's 30 years younger. Like, yeah. That could go really poorly.
I don't want to see a fake version of it. You know what I'm saying? In a long action sequences, it's just,
I don't know if it will work, but if it doesn't, we're dead anyway.
So.
And then, not necessarily in the crosshairs of this particular exchange, but Damon Lindelof had some choice words. Now, he was brought in to write a Star Wars project. And we know he turned in a script and he was out the door. And this was another one where it kind of was like, okay, what's real, what's not? Well, Lindelof put that to rest. He said, I was more than invited. He said, I was more than possibly going to be part of the Star Wars universe. I was invited into it and then asked to leave. Quote.
Wow.
Now, who's he talking about invited him in and asked him to leave? There's only one person with the power to do that. It's Kathleen Kennedy. That's shots fired at Kathleen Kennedy.
Wow. This is a timetable, Brian, as to when she's out. Because this seems like everybody is sort of distancing themselves from doing anything associated with Kathleen Kennedy and Star Wars. Those two names put together.
So, you know, it's tough because they don't, so part of the issue is they don't have a film. And so this is where we want to bring Celebration into this discussion, because yes, they announced three projects, but they did not give you a release date for any of them, which is conspicuous. Like, think about when Marvel does these presentations. Yeah, they wind up moving the dates, but there's always a calendar. So at the rate this is going, I don't think she makes it to 2024. And the reason I say that is because if they want to launch production on a $200 million budgeted Star Wars movie and get it into theaters by 2025, it has to be underway by the end of this year. It has to be. It has to be, you know, pre-pro, casting, story. It has to be well into that by the time we turn the calendar. So if they haven't made any headway on any of these things that she announced, and we'll talk briefly about them, then you're looking at no Star Wars on the big screen until 2026, 2027. Now you're approaching like a decade. And like, I get it, Star Wars went 14 years without anything on the big screen between Return of the Jedi and the special edition re-release. But back then we didn't think about franchise the same way. Yeah. Like you never thought there would be, you know, George Lucas's dream of other movies. So like, nowadays, the idea that you can go 10 years without a single Star Wars movie,
that's
not acceptable to Disney.
Brian, I was watching the first movie, the first three Star Wars episode 1 and 2. I can't believe that joint made it on screen. It was just horrible to watch.
2 is awful, man. Attack of the Clones is, yeah. I told my kid before we went through it, and she watched it. She's like, oh my God. She's like, I'm like, yeah, it is. It should be. It's a terrible movie by far. It's like, you see Natalie Portman in that movie, and you're like, she went on to win an Oscar?
Yeah. Like, but things are reaching a turning point, Brian. Where this could, what would it take, Brian? Because I'm thinking this could be get nasty, or they can, you know, part ways amicably. How do you think this is going to go?
Well, it'll be publicly, it'll be amicably, just because I think, you know, Kathleen Kennedy's long tenure as a producer in Hollywood, you don't typically lop someone like that off unless they do something heinous or illegal.
Yeah.
So it'll be a mutual parting of the ways. I do think Disney wants some space, and I referenced this last time, between the Victoria Alonso situation and this one, if they want to let her go. You don't want to be seen dumping the top two female creatives at your company within like a month.
Yeah.
Not a good look.
Yeah.
You get some heat for that regardless of your justification.
Yeah.
I do think your point last time about the success of Indiana Jones
may lend itself to a possible.
I think it's a fair question to ask whether there are people inside the Disney higher ups that actually would not mind that movie failing because it will make it easier for them to remove her.
Yes.
Yes.
I think that is a fair question to put out there.
Yeah.
Now, Kennedy herself, of course, doesn't stop squawking. So this is a whole other thing that came up post Star Wars Celebration about the films, and we will get to these. Mm-hmm. They were asking about when the movies are coming, because I said no release date. So she says, quote, "I've often brought up James Bond. That's every 3 to 4 years, and there wasn't the pressure to feel like you had to have a movie every year. And I always felt this was very important to Star Wars. We have to eventize this." Rewind.
Mm-hmm.
10 years ago,
okay,
when they started down the path of Rogue One and Solo, Kathleen Kennedy at that time was boasting, "You are now going to get a Star Wars movie
every
single year."
That's now, a bomb, dude.
Listen, I'm all for learning lessons. I'm all for saying something didn't work, we got to change.
Yeah.
What I'm not cool with is when you say you always felt a certain way when you clearly did not and ran the company in a completely different way to such an end that when Solo bombed, you couldn't do it anymore.
Yeah. That's the gambit.
Lying? Laughing? Lying. So, to which I'd say, I am shocked and chagrined. And she is still there. Anyway, so I don't know. I think you're right. I think we are getting to a head. It actually would have been more useful if one of these films was coming out and could actually not either be, could be a mess. You know, like it's almost like if Rise of Skywalker was coming out now, that almost would be more helpful.
Yeah.
Because that became such a mess. But, you know, we have these three projects. I mean, the one that we talked about last time that sparked the rumor was this whole Rey project, which actually was the Lindelof script originally that got scrapped when he was fired. And that's the one they're saying, did she go Renegade on? And that has no release date. But there, you know, there's the rumor is it's 2025 or 2026. But the only one of these three that I think we're going to see is the Filoni one, the one that caps the Mandoverse. That's the only one that makes sense to me, where they've got a base of fandom and storytelling to where they're just going to wrap up multiple shows from Disney Plus with one big film, which is something I think you and I conceptually have always wanted to see Marvel do. And we're apparently going to see them do it. That's the only movie I think you're kind of guaranteed to get from Star Wars in the next couple of years. One, but it's years off, because they want to do, the rumor is they want to do a season four of Mando. We got to get Ashoka on the board, which I am still very excited
about. Yeah.
And then there's still the TBD of, like, are they going to do anything more with Boba Fett? I hope not. I don't think we need it. This would not connect to Kenobi. That does not, there's no, they're definitely not getting that.
Yeah.
But then there's also, like, are they going to loop in, are there any connections to some of the other ones? Like, you have the John Watts skeleton crew, the show we're actually legit excited about, which is the Acolyte. Cause that footage looked like they found something.
I cannot wait for that.
That's the one, guys. If you can find the leaked footage of that, and, like, you see
when that joint comes out, oh my god, when that joint comes out, when people see the trailer for that and the footage that they showed for that, oh man, nostalgia.
We get, yeah, because
Channel
get,
5.
We get legit Star Wars martial arts epic starring the Sith. That is something that I think people will come out for.
Of course.
But, like, do you think, for example, we also got the James Mangold interesting idea of almost like a biblical epic, right? The Ten Commandments of Star Wars.
I like
do you
to
think
see that.
Ever, I would like want to see it, but do you think we ever see it?
This would be, I mean... The only way Kathleen Kennedy continues doing is that if she wants to stay around, she has to make a movie, right? A Star Wars movie, she has to make a movie. If this is one of the movies that she's helming, it's a very interesting concept, Brian. I like it very much, in seeing how this all came about. That's always something that somebody wants to see, how this all came about. If she could pull it off, Brian, or it could be a massive bomb and there you go, she's gone. But that's a year or 2 years out.
Oh, I think it's much more than that, if I'm being honest. I mean, so I think there's the interlocking parts to this that make me feel like I still think it's less than 50% we see this movie is, number one, James Mangold is the director of Indiana Jones 5. Now, he is a good director, but if that movie bombs, it will certainly hamstring his ability
to get
the pull in the budget to make this Star Wars movie. The second thing that makes me nervous is that in classic Kathleen Kennedy fashion, this project is basically was announced on the basis of one conversation. Mangold apparently went to her and said, this is my idea. And she said, yes. And she announced it. And, like,
she did a Blade.
Yeah. And, you know, and we will talk about that in another show. Look how that's going. Just the track record when you have that little meat on the bone.
Yeah.
Is not great. And like, look at all the creatives that Kathleen Kennedy has shuffled in and out, right? Dating back, we talked about Solo. Like, you had the Lord and Miller from the Lego movie, we're supposed to do that movie. Then they get fired, Ron Howard comes in. And then, you know, we talked about Lindelof coming and going, and you've had director Patty Jenkins, you know, Rogue Squadron. They actually filmed a video with her, like, boarding an X-Wing and talking about how much it meant to her father as a former fighter pilot. And I got excited about that. I thought it was a good idea. That's not happening. Like, so my point is, when they have these movies that are basically built on the backbone of just one elevator pitch, I just don't think we can buy into it until we actually see, like, pre-production, casting, like, real crew being put onto these. And we don't have that for any of these projects. That's why I say the Filoni one is the only one where I think there's substance.
Very interesting stuff. Anything else, Brian, before we wrap this one up?
No, I mean, I felt just in light of the response people gave, we wanted to go more down the rabbit hole of this, because there is. But do yourself, if you are interested in this, do yourself a favor and just Google, like, Kathleen Kennedy Feige, Kathleen Kennedy Root. There's a lot floating out there about this. It is wild.
But I would assume that for new people who are sort of, I don't know, maybe pro Kennedy, I don't know, who have been following this and don't know the details, there's a lot of, you know, if you go back, somebody saying one thing and then right now somebody saying something completely different. I mean, it happens, but we cannot have this Star Wars franchise be on the shelf for this long without any concrete plans for the future. It just seems like we're throwing out concepts out there and announcing these things to see what sort of reaction we get. And it's being misled and it's being held hostage.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
And to put it in perspective, like right now you have neither Star Wars nor Star Trek at the movies for the first time since 1976. I mean, look at the count. I mean, either one of those franchises was active with a big screen project at every point along the way since that time. And we got neither right now. Yeah.
That's our show for today. Please let us know in the comment section below what you guys think of all this. Hit that like and subscribe button, and we'll see you next time on the Nerd Gen Report.
The show goes on! Yeah!